The US is back on board with the Paris Agreement. Now the real work begins. I'm Shannon Osaka, and I cover climate policy for Grist. Ever think to yourself, wow, the world should really come together and do something about climate change? Well, it already has, sort of. So back in 2015, hundreds of countries got together at a big international meeting in Paris, and they pledged to limit global warming to 2 degrees Celsius, or if they could swing it, 1.5 degrees Celsius. Unfortunately, it wasn't exactly a legally binding agreement. It was more like kind of a general shared goal, reinforced by a healthy dose of public shaming.
Shame.
Every year, countries come together at these big international meetings, and they bring their goals to cut carbon emissions. Is it working? Kind of. Since 2015, emissions have actually kept climbing up until last year. As of right now, a bunch of countries have promised to totally zero out their emissions by 2050. But all of those pledges still aren't enough to keep us on the pathway to avoiding the worst climate impacts. The US is responsible for 15% of the world's total carbon emissions. And in 2017, President Donald Trump said this.
The United States will withdraw from the Paris Climate Accord.
Okay, so then the 2020 election happened, and all of a sudden, the US wanted back in. But if the US wants to come back to an actual warm welcome, then it's gonna have to do a pretty big gesture, like pledge to cut emissions by 45 to 50%. Other countries are gonna wanna see results. Executive action, money, and most importantly, some kind of climate legislation from the US Congress. No matter what happens, having the US back in the Paris fold is going to be pretty good for the climate. For the past 4 years, some countries like Australia, Brazil, Saudi Arabia have kind of been hiding behind the bad behavior of the US and not really being their best climate selves. Now they'll be forced back into the spotlight. And the US could finally follow through on its original promise to give billions of dollars to poorer countries to help them build clean energy and adapt to the overheating planet. So even though the US rejoining the Paris Agreement is pretty much the lowest possible bar for addressing climate change, it's still a really big deal. But the real work is what comes next.